as a paramedic, as a firefighter, we get into this profession because we want to help people. And when you're a paramedic and a firefighter in a rural environment, you're helping people with fewer resources and more austere environment than you would in a larger city. So when we get a call for a chest pain patient, on the way, we're thinking, okay, this is an AzREADI type call. And when we get on scene, you know, we'll start our assessment. We'll usually run a 12 lead because that's really important diagnostic information.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
My name's Emma. I'm a paramedic. That's Peter. He's my EMT today. What's your name?
I'm Joanne.
So why are we here, Joanne?
My chest started hurting and got hard for me to breathe.
Yeah. Okay. If it's okay with you, why don't we just get a really quick set of vitals on you and take a look at your heart and then see what we want to do from there, okay?
Okay.
All right. And I'm going to go ahead and call a doctor and kind of get their opinion too. Does that sound all right?
Yeah, and anything to get feeling better.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm scared because this has never happened before.
Hey, Dr. Gaither. Yeah, can you hear me?
Good.
Perfect. All right.
So AzREADI, AzREADI, is a grant-funded project that's run out of the University of Arizona Center for Rural Health. What the grant is aimed to do is to bring telemedicine services to our rural EMS communities. It really brings physician-level care to communities that might not have good access to that care. In the last 4 or 5 years, a new service has become available across the United States called FirstNet. That FirstNet service is a wireless communication service that's dedicated to first responders. With that new innovation, we thought this was a great opportunity to try out this program and see if it really did improve care for our rural communities. For the AzREADI project, what we really focus on is providing care, for example, for patients with chest pain. Before this program, if you developed horrible, crushing chest pain, the paramedic would just call the helicopter and transport you to the hospital as quickly as possible. With this program, the paramedic can get an EKG, send that EKG to our physicians, we'll take a look at the EKG, talk with the patient, and help come up with a decision. Is this patient okay to be transported by ground, by an ambulance, or can they even go by their own vehicle, saving that individual money and allowing the paramedic to stay in the community to provide the services that community needs?
So as operations chief at Sonoita-Elgin Fire District, my job is really to oversee the day-to-day running of the department. So making sure that our crews are scheduled and they have what they need. Also responsible for the stuff around here. So making sure that our vehicles are on the road and running correctly. And then really anything else that the fire chief needs me to do to make sure that we're basically mission ready every single day. Being in a rural community, you know, and by ambulance, we're roughly 45 to 90 minutes away from a hospital, depending on where we pick the patient up and which hospital we go to. Sonoita-Elgin Fire serves a fire district of 350 square miles. We also are responsible for ambulance transports for 725 square miles.
You know, no stoplights. We have a Dollar General now, which makes us a little bit bigger, but before it was just a corner market store, one gas station, you know, very spread out. Rural EMS is a whole different animal. You really have to kind of cowboy up and just do what you can with what you have. As a provider, I like it in that way because it really tests you and makes you grow. You know, whether you like it or not, sometimes you definitely learn from every call that you get. Spending an hour in the back of the rig with a patient, you're either really busy doing stuff or you're, you know, having a nice conversation with them and getting to learn about them and getting to learn about their family. And at least for this hour, I'm going to get you to the hospital safely and I'm going to, you know, kind of comfort you and make you feel a little bit better on your way there.
We're less than 15 minutes out.
Cool, thank you.
The way in which this program makes my job easier, frankly, but also more fulfilling, is that between myself and my patient and the ER physician I'm bringing this patient to, I don't have to wait until I get to the hospital to actually link all the parties together. I can do it from the point of our initial encounter with the patient. now that we've been running the program for several months, we've entered into refresher trainings. And refresher trainings is kind of what it sounds like. It's going back and make sure we remember it. How do we use this phone?
Okay. So, hi, thank you for coming. My name is AILEEN HARDCASTLE. I am the project manager for the AzREADI program out of the University of Arizona Department of
the refresher trainings, you know, especially for this AzREADI program, I think will be really helpful for us.
So AzREADI is the Arizona Rural Advanced Telemedicine Demonstration Initiative.
It'll help. What are some things that we need to be doing different, or what are some things we could be doing different to help the situation?
A lot of people in a lot of places are looking at what we're doing and specifically what you guys are doing.
And hopefully expand it beyond, you know, just chest pains, and we can make it into that, you know, more of a, you know, use me whenever for whatever kind of tool.
So Dr. Gaither is the person who's on call today, and he's ready to accept test calls at any point.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Can you guys hear me okay?
Yep.
My goal throughout my entire career has been to really help these talented healthcare providers utilize their skills and resources as best as they can. So this project really does allow them to do that. The striking thing about medicine is I, as a physician, rarely save a life. The paramedics and EMTs in our community are the real heroes. They're the real lifesavers. One of the great things about this program is that it allows those individuals to get a doctor on a phone to do a telemedicine consult during those really high stress, life critical times. If they have a question, this allows them to get a hold of us and we can help them through those really challenging situations.
Frankly, if this makes a difference for one patient, it's made a huge difference. I would love it if more agencies that we interacted with and more fire districts in rural communities were able to basically participate in this, because we've seen the difference it makes for us. And if it's helping us and it's helping our patients, then I know it's going to help other rural patients in other districts.
You know, it's kind of my life goal, I suppose, is to do whatever I can to build myself so that I can be like, you know, I like to think of it as like a servant to other people. I really do genuinely get that enjoyment of, you know, if I'm able to, you know, make that personal connection with somebody in the ambulance for an hour and just talk to them about their day, you know, or talk to them about their life, being able to be there and be the, you know, the person that somebody needs in that moment. I just want to be able to look back and say that I made some kind of impact in their lives, if it was for an hour or 2 hours or, you know, 20 minutes, it doesn't matter. But as long as I could do whatever I could to be able to be there and be the best, you know, person that they needed in that moment.